So once again briefly, so far explained concepts from amino acids. The chemical substances which consist of one amino functional group, one acid functional groups are called as amino acids. Based on the position of acid and amine, different types of amino acids are available, alpha, beta, gamma and delta. So most are all the naturally available amino acids are alpha amino acids, and they are exist in L configuration but not in D configuration. Here in the next one, out of the 20 amino acids available naturally, some of the amino acids cannot biosynthesized in animal body. Such amino acids are called as essential amino acids. Those amino acids which can biosynthesized in animal body are called as non-essential amino acids. And in one more type, neutral amino acids, basic amino acids, acidic amino acids, and their examples, followed by in solution state, by transfer of hydrogen atom in the form of H plus towards the amine group, the amino acids generally exist in the form of dipolar character. Such dipolar form of amino acids is called as deuterions. These deuterions are amphoteric in character or amphoteric in nature. So once again, what is amphoteric in nature means dual character. That means amino acids may react with acids as well as react with bases. And next, all are available in L form only. This is the most important news regarding amino acids. All naturally available amino acids are L form only. After this, let us learn about structure of protein. Structure of protein. As per our previous cases, proteins are essential chemical substances that must require for living organism. So these proteins are made up of alpha amino acids. So now in this class, we have to explain the structural aspects of proteins. So once again, all proteins are made up of amino acids, that to alpha amino acids. They are made up of alpha amino acids. Next one, when one amino acids, so I would like to consider RCHCOOH NH2. This is one amino acid combines with another amino acid like RCHCOOH. Remember, the amino acids which wants to interact with each other may be same or may be different. So whatever it is, they may be same or different. One amino acid interacts with another amino acids, their loss of water molecule takes place between them. So how they are going to lose water molecule? To explain the mechanistic proof, I want to take this. So I want to write acid functional group as C double bond O O H. This is the carboxylic acid functional group of first amino acid, and this is the amino functional group of second amino acid. Now OH minus and H plus. OH minus from acid, H plus from amine. OH minus plus H plus combinedly loss of water molecule. There CRCHNH2, it is C double bond O. What is the next expected one? The carbonyl is going to make bond with nitrogen of second amino acid. Here NH CH RCOOH, and this is the most important one. What it is? Amide linkage or amide bond. This amide bond resulting from addition of two same or different amino acids is called as peptide bond. It is called as peptide bond. Amide bond resulting in between two different or two same amino acids with the loss of water molecule is called as peptide bond. Here, the peptide bond produced from how many amino acids? This is one amino acid. This is another amino acids. So, this is the amide linkage or peptide bond resulting by the addition of two amino acids. Then it is called as dipeptide bond. What is that bond? Is dipeptide bond. What is dipeptide bond? The amide bond or peptide bond resulting from two amino acids is called as dipeptide. Similarly, to this dipeptide, I want to add one more amino acid like NH2CH or COOH. To the formed dipeptide, I want to add one more amino acid. The same thing takes place. Hydrogen from amine, OH from acid eliminated out, loss of water molecule, then starts from here up, R CH NH2 C double bond O NH CH R C double bond O NH CH R COOH. So come to this, this is one peptide bond, this is another peptide bond. So identify how many peptide bonds are there? Two peptide bonds, but these two peptide bonds are resulting by the addition of three amino acids. Hence it is called as tripeptide bond or tripeptide. To this tripeptide, now I want to add one more amino acid, then the resulting peptide is called as tetrapeptide. That means by the stepwise addition of amino acids, first we can produce dipeptide resulting from two amino acids, then tripeptide resulting from three amino acids, the next one tetrapeptide resulting from the addition of four amino acids, similarly pentapeptide, hexapeptide, heptapeptide. Finally, when huge amount of amino acids are mixed together, then the resulting compound is called as polypeptide. What is poly here? More number. Polypeptide means more number. When more number of same or different amino acids reacted with each other via connecting with a peptide bond, so such peptide is called as polypeptide. So this is the way of peptide bond formation between two amino acids. Here the polypeptides having hundreds of amino acids with more than 10,000 U atomic weight or sorry molecular weight are called as proteins. These are called as proteins. Once again, when two amino acids mixed together, the resulting is called as dipeptide. When three amino acids reacted with each other, tripeptide. When four amino acids reacted with each other, tetrapeptide. When five amino acids reacted with each other, pentapeptide. The same one, when hundreds of amino acids reacts with each other to form peptide bond, then the resulting a long peptide chain is called as polypeptide. So once again, poly means more number of amino acids reacted with each other to produce a long peptide chain, polypeptide. Generally, how can we differentiate polypeptide from a protein? So polypeptide means huge number of amino acids reacted with each other via peptide bond. Here, connected with each other via peptide bond. Generally, those polypeptides which are having hundreds of amino acids with more than 10,000 AMU or recently derived units are U, molecular weight are called as proteins. In some cases, Some polypeptides which are having less amount of amino acids are also considered as proteins. Example, insulin. Actually, insulin is a protein made up of 51 amino acids only. Of course, it is made up of 51 amino acids. This polypeptide is also called as protein. Right? So, this is about way of bond formation between two different or two same amino acids. That is the bond formation, peptide bond formation, polypeptide and proteins.